So what do you think about on starting item? Should not it be a corrupting potion?
Mean
okay, we're going to see a first gank in the top lane, and early gank goes in and forces Trundle to use the flash.
Okay. Trundle flashes early. Owner said he didn't put a ward in the top side brush yet. Olaf can look to gank here, they don't know.
Olaf is looking for a gank in the top lane.
Yeah, it's not warded. Sejuani
goes in. And Ornn might have to use his flash too, yeah. Both the junglers gank top lane first and burns the flash.
Yeah. Interestingly enough, Ornn had a ward, but I think he wasn't expecting Olaf to show up immediately.
Okay, we see a fight over the Sutter in the top of the river, and Sejuani is winning the trade.
You don't think?
Joins in and picks up the first blood.
That was pretty cool.
That was pretty nice.
So, this is going to be an even harder time for Zoe in the lane now.
4k with double buffs. That is yikes.
This is the power of tank hunter now, right? Okay, Corki finds Olaf in the jungle.
Know that they're doing the herald.
Corki uses the package. I think that was to disengage there.
Yeah. But
he's trying to take the focus away from Sejuani during the rift herald.
Will Sejuani keep in the herald is a question though. Trundle is coming down. But so it's okay. Nautilus.
Braum and Nautilus also roams.
Probably gonna.
I think they will back out unless they want to fight it out.
Herald resets. Got a Trundle here, and they burst him before.
Okay, see, so we see hitting fight in the top lane. Braum takes a big kill on the Trundle, and this might be an easy win for the 14k. Yeah.
Yeah, Nautilus back there early. Braum was still there.
Zoe faced Jax blindly, but they're going to run away.
Nautilus is there.
No, I think Zoe might be able to snipe him.
Whoa, that was pretty.
He just has to back off.
With Zoe throwing in Battle Stars from Fog of War, it's kind of risky, especially with Sejuani at that hill.
Yeah, and we all know how good Shiki is with that. Like in the late game, he's really, really annoying with the Zoe.
Yeah. Otherwise, definitely have, in my opinion, the stronger mid game though.
Okay, so Nautilus gets caught out.
This is caught out.
He flashes into the wall.
Kisana.
Misfortune flashes in and will be able to pick up a second kill comfortably. Or not, Misfortune lives just by the tail. Sejuani is trying to pick up the kill.
My sniper with the ult here.
Yep. The ult doesn't let
him. Sides of the ult. Still dies. In the situation over there.
14k BP seems to be dominating this early game.
So Drake's up again, so they're definitely gonna get this Draco's. They have that one ward behind the dragon pit in the bush, but then that's not gonna do much for them, so they're definitely gonna get a free Drake here.
Yeah. So what do you think of the misplay by Nautilus over there? Like, was that a panic flash, or maybe he like pressed the flash while he was still stunned?
I think that was just honestly a panic flash, because if he flashes over the wall to this side, then he just walks out.
Yeah. Okay, we see the Rift Herald being spawned in the mid lane. They pick up 3 third plates. Yeah, I think the Corki sidestepped well.
Yeah.
Okay, Ornn is going in on Trundle in the top lane. Sejuani joins the fight, misses the ult by a bit. Corki Trundle takes so much airborne there. And finally goes down.
Trundle just gets CC chain.
Gisna jumps on Misfortune. He should not be going in. Okay, he picks up the kill, might be able to jump out. And he does. Meanwhile, we see a gank in the mid lane. It's a 3v2. Braum is taking a lot of damage and finally goes down.
finally, Utura Boys is on the board.
Utura Boys has their first kill.
Then, damn, the Tristana getting a solo kill on the Misfortune 1v1 under turret.
I think 14k is going to get their first turret in the top lane. Okay, Sage when he goes in, it's bubbles.
I think he's taking up a lot of damage here.
Okay, he flashes for the Olaf. Almost gets
that
them
is,
and Corky picks up a kill.
Wow.
Going in for the second one. He picks up a second kill. He might go for a triple.
Kill? Oh, that's really good. Very nice triple.
Amazing play by Corky there. Okay, we're going to see a team fight in the bot lane as well. Tristana joins the team fight.
The TP
so decides to work back, but Olaf gets ulted. This person ults, but Shigella gets in one. Sejuani picks up the kill. Corky joins the battle, dealing a lot of damage.
MF trying to finish up the kill. MF gets the kill on Tristana, another one for Zoe. With all of that CC, this is especially where the long range Sejuani ult and the long range Ornn ult engage help a lot, because UB have a harder time walking in for vision. They have the those ults available.
Okay, Zoe gets caught out in a bad position, flashes out, and we see an ult lands, picks up three people, but doesn't really do much of a damage. And Olaf is running Rampage on Ornn, but Ornn is tanking all day, and we see Sejuani going down.
He's getting free damage here. MF is untouched.
Yeah. They need to focus the carry. They need to focus the carry instead of Ornn.
Ornn survives somehow. Braum is dead.
Misfortune needs to deal some more damage. I think she should be able to pick up the double kill. Braum passive kills him.
Good
round
from Orient
Jet
and they
played. I think Utara Boys actually misplayed that team fight in the end.
He hears that like Zoe could.
Okay, Sejuani ult finds Nautilus there, going in hard for him. And Braum passive lands and is going to be killed. MF ults at a good time. MF. Okay, it's not a smart thing to pick up a fight in such a narrow corridor against the Misfortune unless they have a Braum shield up. Okay, they started the battle. Misfortune and Trundle both are at the base. Trundle has teleport though. He finally decides to teleport.
Look at the band, look at the band. It's burning so fast.
Yeah.
Can one get there?
Whoa, that was a steal!
This might be the turning point for Utara Boys. Misfortune finally asks.
They need to save the Baron.
She needs to live. Ornn lands and she goes down.
Try and melt through the tanks as fast as she can and leave the burst damage up to Corky.
It's just amazing. Okay,
Corky goes in. Corky goes in a whole load of damage. Look at the Corky damage. MF dies but trades it with Tristana.
Okay, that's the way too.
With a 10, that's a 10.
It might just be the game for 14k.
Corky is alive, he can just spam machine block. Flashes over the wall.
Okay. So they do have 20 seconds on the clock still.
He's gonna get CC changed by Sejuani and Ornn, even if they try to do something.
Ornn goes for the ult. Land the ult on not left.
And so.
Yeah,
almost.
Oh my god. Look.
Okay, well, Sephiroth just burned his flash, but then again, Corky K has no mana here. Corky might be down, and Corky gets down and gets taken by. Okay, they're continuing this fight. This looks bad. This looks bad for Utara Boys now. They might get a.
Goes over to Utara Boys. It's actually VP14K who get three of them back. And look at the top side, RTO looking for the solo kill. He might not get it. In fact, he dies. And it's a one for one, but wow, that was pretty close. And in just a minute, Finn, we went from zero kills to six kills.
Okay, Syndra's there.
Yeah, Cinder does not have ult mind you, is level 7.
But then again, Corki is there right now with the package. Okay, this looks pretty scary for the Syndra here. Yep, I think Dastan's gonna.
Now the package being crazy. One more QE from Shiki might make him survive this. A beautiful QE. Shiki is slightly behind because of the global gold lead. And
yep.
Look at this, all the gold pin is being funneled to the dagger.
Oh, okay, Hecarim stop side. Yeah, oh no, it's not an Hecarim, it's an Alistar.
Yeah, they will try to go for the Darius. Darius does not have ult, mind you. Chungus would be like, you know what, I just want to kill the Herald and go away.
Mm-hmm.
And a ghost gets blown, but that's about it. And a couple of platings just go down. So I would, if I was on right there, I'd just go ham. Yes, he is. Oh, wait, what? Rampage? Okay, never mind. He gets the hit. He could have
okay, that's
it.
And that's it for the Darius.
And they should give it to the Hecarim at this point because they want the jungler to be ahead. And for whatever reason, they decide not to. They're not even getting the assists on it. I don't know why you're sending two people top. You're not going to get assisted by Sephir.
Okay, RTO just popped off his ghost. He's going for the kill.
No tower. Rampage is at the absolute worst time right here. He can still survive if he uses ult, but let's see if it's enough or not. He might be able to solo. What? The word are we living in? Oh, never mind. He doesn't.
That was a very close call.
2-0 Bickert. It's looking close, I'm not going to lie, and the Udyr is looking for a bad engage right now and steps into like the wrong shoes and still somehow survives. And how often can he? Cannot, does not have flash right there. And look at this, Shiki is in trouble though. Here comes Dastan, a nice usage of the shield, and Hecarim comes as well. And look in the bot lane, what is this? When fights happen, why does
what a turnaround.
Bot lane dies again, Dastan dies again, red one does not get the kill. It's actually Big Chungus dude who takes it. But in a span of just 30 seconds, a 3-4-0 happens, and suddenly Uttara boys get themselves a
back on the driver's seat.
Yep. On Uttara boys, all ultimates are up. We are in for an exciting fight at the third dragon, guys. Will it be VT14K with this Udyr, or will it gonna be Uttara boys who might get this advantage? We'll have to wait and watch. Level 10 to level 10, so smites are equal at this point. He misses on ulti being used, Rom ulti also being used, but does not see the right person. The jump is made, Red Bro jumps in, does not ultimate. Yes, he does. The misfortune lands as well.
Oh, Sephiroth with the godlike item.
The Vayne is untouched, Vayne. The Vayne is untouched. Darius is here as well. Can the Darius to get the Vayne? No, he cannot. Orn is doing so much damage. At the end of the day, it's a beautiful double stun right here. And it's a 2-3 at the end of the day, but they're still looking to fight. Vayne is alive, but look at misfortune. Misfortune gets a shutdown on the main, but Syndra will good look to get the kill. And wow, what a close fight we've had so far from bits of four.
And that's gonna be an ace. Hopefully.
Can Shiki look to get? He's had a great team fight with this Syndra. Not gonna lie, his stuns have been on point. I do not know if they can kill Rip here. Nobody gets a dragon, everyone blows their ultimates, and we might just see this happen the next minute as well because the dragon is still not gone anywhere.
Yeah.
It's actually Darius who takes it, and Red One could be in trouble right there. He's gonna have to do one more auto.
Oh my god,
he
MF
gets
is condemned
off.
And MF is gonna get killed.
Yeah, MF is condemned as well, and that's gonna be Vayne who gets the kill. Dastan versus World Sephiroth. Dastan is trying to do as much damage as he can with Udi as well, and Dastan will get him, but on the other side, RTO will die to the process as well. Let's see what happens, and I'm looking at RTO as well. If someone has to do something, it's gonna be RTO.
Bro,
it
I'm waiting for the. I'm really looking at Corki's position here because Corki is so far back behind, and with Udyr in the back, this might.
Yeah.
Let's see how this.
This might be given away. Yeah. There's nothing they can do. There's so much zone potential. Oh, he tried to steal it with the flash, failed. That's a beautiful ultimate, and I'm a critic. I will die in the process. Hecarim survives. I have no idea how.
Ornn died before doing one knockoff.
The ultimate from Syndra kills him. His fortune. Alistar jumps on the Corki. World Sephiroth's like, this is my game to win. I'm gonna go to a game 3. Gets a double kill for himself. 4-1.
If you look at Syndra here, she is up in CS. She is up in kills. And that's what I told you about. We all know how good Shiki is on that Syndra. You just cannot let comfort pick like that go away.
Oh, this could be difficult for Red Bro.
Corki
is
with
not
a brilliant package.
Red Bro might die here, but look at the damage on the Vayne. How much damage? The Darius gets shredded. The Ornn ultimate kills the Braum. Misfortune's getting Zhonya to death, I would say, here at this point. That's a 3-0, and I think this could be the game right here.
But I don't think that's going to help them
I don't think it matters. If the next wave comes and there's nobody to defend, oh, this could be crazy because VP14 can realize they can't fight 5v5. They're trying to play the split push game to see if they can do something. Now it depends on the conviction of these guys. Man, with the mid inhibitor up, there's no way.
Oh my god, they just ruined the MF Sultan.
Yeah,
that's it for now.
Interrupted
the misfortune
ult on ult, Ekrem ult, ult after ult, wombo after wombo, Vayne after Vayne, I would say.
Vayne just went ham at the backline and there's nothing they can do about it.
Yeah, this was game. The moment they got the Baron and the Vayne scaled to become the challenge that he is.
That was really well played. That was really well played by Ornn. That was a brilliant CC on the
This could be the end of the game. I don't know why they're not going for it. Just go and end the game, guys. You're
They're going to end it.
Yeah, thank you. And this is going to be game 2 going very convincingly in favor of Uttara Gaming. Uttara Gaming did not go down without fight or Corki will die as well. Udyr will just be Udyr. He's been 1-3-6 for the last 15 minutes in the game. In the top lane, the CS is around the 10 or 12. Not much has changed. Both the flashes are now up.
Okay, we see three people at mid lane looking for a gank.
Yeah, Cheeky's gonna be in trouble though, but Cheeky has his backup. He jumps onto them. What is gonna happen? Teleport also be coming. Cheeky has to run away, but Cheeky might die first. But I'm a creative player, like, you know, behind in CS, but I'll be the first one to get a lead. But here comes Maokai. Maokai presses Q on to Janna, but Janna will not die. Runs away. Warwick has to flash out. Rampage has to die, but here comes. Wait, who was it? It was the Alistar actually who came in and they get a kill back, but it's still a 2-for-1 at the end of the day, and it's two kills going out to VP14K. They were the ones who made this happen.
I think this was a misplayed from the Warwick. Like, he should
100%. Here comes a flash. Here comes a flash. WQ. The Ignite here as well. The Janna shield as well. This is not lowing well. Cool dude didn't realize that there was backup for Dastan. And now he will die himself. That's two more kills going over. And I'm a QT bro. Like, I'm going to avenge myself this game. Picks himself up 3 kills in this skirmish right now. And he's going to be really happy. The most of the advantages in the mid lane and the jungle. And look at this, Cheeky is in trouble again. Cheeky gets grounded, Cheeky can't eat. And Dastan slays. You wanted the kill in the Cassiopeia, Mugiwara, here you go. Cool dude again. Oh, this is looking like a bad, bad trade right here. Yet again, cool dude finds himself trying to roam. But I'm a QT bro, just being there in the right place, the right timing. Now, VP14K looking really good. So I'm not sure what the game plan here is. Here comes Rampage as well. Chungus dude yet again gets caught out, but this time he has ultimate. He gets the flash EQ. There is no Syndra ult used yet. A beautiful on combo. Gets a double stun. It's a beautiful use of the flash of the Warwick W as well. But this is a fight that Uttara boys are like, hey guys, free mid lane tower. Let's get it. And they got themselves a free tower without losing anything. Never mind, Warwick could be in trouble here. Warwick has to flash away. There's a nice, nice W. Alistar all comes in for a damage. Warwick uses to ult the Ornn, but Warwick will die in the process. Here comes Rek'Sai. Rek'Sai wants to jump on the Jinx. He will look to get the Jinx. Jinx is running away. No, he won't. I'm a QT, bro. What a god you are, man. Gets the target at the right time. It's a beautiful double stun there on. And Cheeky, as much as he tries to run away, uses the ult on the Rek'Sai. Does not do enough. The Hexdrinker, the Hexdrinker passive allows him. That's a straight up ace. And VP14K completely annihilate Uttara boys in this team fight.
Okay, mind.
Cool dude's gonna die. Oh, the jump failed, I think, at this point, and the E failed, and everything in life that could have failed, failed. Dastan failed, everything failed, but when everything is said and done, cool dude is laughing merrily. He will eventually die. And real one comes from behind, red one, sorry, he runs away, and here comes Warwick. And Warwick will die, and here comes Ornn trying to kill the Syndra. Can he succeed? Can he not? We'll have to wait and watch. One more Q is what it takes. And there you go. The bait was enough right there. Flash is being used. Jinx trying to do what she can to survive. Maokai being alone right there. Not going to be enough. And this could potentially be game right here. Because Maokai and Jinx are the only people left. And finally, VP14K is like, you know what, let's get the inhibitor, guys, and let's try to win the game.
Okay, so we think we have our first semi-finalist here.
Let's see if they can end the game. There's 16 seconds for the Syndra, 4 seconds for the Warwick, and 30 for the Mark. Yeah, I think they should be able to end this. Rek'Sai might die, though. Rek'Sai is in trouble. His Hexdrinker pops up, but he's okay. Warwick is here as well. Warwick does not do anything. His W also is not enough. Dastan just melts him out of oblivion. And honestly, what a stomp we have seen in game 3. VP14K came to play. They came to win. And they will make it as the first semifinalist of the Legends of the Rift tournament.